Kirchhoff second law. Kirchhoff second law is known as voltage law. Kirchhoff second law must be applied for a loop. That means closed loop. Kirchhoff second law is according to the conservation of energy. Conservation of energy. Kirchhoff second law is known as voltage law. Kirchhoff second law is applicable for only a closed loop, and Kirchhoff second law is according to the conservation of energy. Now, suppose let us consider this is a cell. These are the resistors. This is a complex electrical circuit. EMF of the cell, EMF of the cell, EMF of the cell. What are the resistors? R1, R2, R3. How many are the EMFs? E1, E2, E3, 3. Next one. How many are the resistors? R1, R2, R3. These cells will supply the energy, resistors will utilize the energy. Whatever the energy is supplied by the cell, that energy can be utilized by the resistors. Here in this electrical circuit, E1, E2, E3 are the energy suppliers. R1, R2, R3 are the energy utilizers. According to the conservation of energy, whatever the energy supplied by the cell is equals to energy utilized by number of utilizers. Suppose, for example, right, this total energy supplied by the cell, let us consider 10 joules per coulomb. For every coulomb of charge, these are supplying 10 joules. Right, this is a resistor, it may utilize, that is 2 joules per coulomb, it may utilize 3 joules per coulomb, it may utilize 5 joules per coulomb. According to the Kirchhoff second law, in a closed loop, the energy supplied by the cell 10 joules per coulomb. This 10 joules per coulomb is distributed among the three resistors. Example, 2 joules of coulomb, 3 joules per coulomb, this 5 joules per coulomb. 2 joules per coulomb, 3 joules per coulomb, 5 joules per coulomb. If you add these three, 10 joules per coulomb. Here, according to that diagram, for example, these three may supply the energy 10 joules per coulomb. These 10 joules per coulomb are utilized among the resistors, may be equally, may not be equally. According to the resistors, the energy can be distributed. Therefore, here according to Kirchhoff second law. Now, what is the statement of the Kirchhoff second law? The algebraic sum of potential differences in a closed loop is equals to zero. Here, what is the symbol? Algebraic. What is the potential difference? V is equals to zero. This is a statement. In a closed loop, the algebraic sum of potential differences is equals to zero. I am saying potential differences. Sometimes there is a potential drop. Sometimes there is a potential rise. Sometimes we are able to travel in a path, the potential is to be raised. Sometimes we are able to travel, potential is to be decreased. Potential is going to be dropped. What I am saying means, in a closed loop, the algebraic sum of potential differences is equals to zero. I am saying potential difference. Sometimes there is an increase in potential, sometimes there is a decrease in potential. Decrease in potential, there is a difference. Increase in potential, there is a difference. Here you want to take the algebraic sum of potential differences in a closed loop is equals to zero. This may be stated in other words. Algebraic sum of EMFs plus algebraic sum of product of currents and resistance is equals to zero. This is another statement. Here the sum of algebraic sum of EMFs in a circuit and the algebraic sum of products of currents and resistances in various branches of the electrical circuit is equals to zero. Once again I want to say, here there is a plus. The sum of algebraic sum of EMFs and the algebraic sum of products of currents and resistances in various branches of the electrical circuit is equals to zero. But while doing the problems, generally this is the statement we can utilize. Algebraic sum of EMFs plus algebraic sum of I into R is equals to zero. Now here is also there is a algebraic sum. Whenever there is an algebraic sum, once again we want to use the sign convention. What is the sign convention? Sign convention. What is the sign convention? First one, potential drop is taken as negative. Potential drop is taken as negative. That is, V is negative. And potential drop is taken as negative means whenever the current higher potential to lower potential. We are choosing higher potential to lower potential. Higher potential to lower potential. Therefore, potential is said to be negative. Second one, potential rise. Potential rise. That potential rise is taken as positive. That means positive potential. Positive potential. Now, lower potential to higher potential. Lower potential to higher potential. What is the sign convention? Potential drop is taken as negative. Potential rise is taken as positive. Potential drop is taken as negative. Potential rise is taken as positive. Now, next one. There is a systematic steps. There are systematic steps which are involved while applying the Kirchhoff second law. Let us consider a simple electrical circuit. Now, first one, example. Now, this is the circuit. This is the circuit. What is the EMF of the cell? E is the EMF of the cell. Right. What is the resistance? R is the resistance. Right. Let us consider this cell is considered as an ideal cell whose internal resistance is said to be zero. Now this is called a simple electrical circuit for which I want to apply Kirchhoff second law, that is called Kirchhoff voltage law. After observing the circuit, right, name the circuit. Name the circuit means this is called point A, this is called point B, this is called point C, this is called point D. A, B, C, D. Now, after naming the circuit, now do the current distribution. The current distribution may be started at any point in the circuit, and you want to reach the same point after distributing the current.